Childish Gambino is one of the most multifaceted artists of our generation. His latest table-shaking pop culture moment comes in the form of the music video for This Is America. The video features Glover in an act of somewhat twisted but deep stage presence as the visual unfolds. However, there are a lot of things you guys most likely all missed while watching this music video. So today, we are going to actually continue our first upload of hidden messages inside this music video as we uncover 10 things you missed in This Is America. Be sure to watch this entire video because you are not going to want to miss out on what we have today. Before we get started, we have some new apparel available now, down below. It's on sale for a very short time, so be sure to pick something up. Don't catch you slipping, no. Look what I'm whipping. Number 10. Donald Glover wears Confederate-style trousers throughout the video. Now, this is one of the more subtle visual cues. The Confederate-style trousers are visible in almost every scene in This Is America. In U.S. history, Confederate soldiers fought to keep slaves from being freed, ultimately losing out to Union forces in 1865. The trousers are, perhaps, a nod to this time period, a subtle but persistent reminder of America's complicated relationship with Confederate monuments and the remnants of slavery. But what's also interesting is that Gambino himself is seen wearing these Confederate pants. As an African-American man, I doubt he would be supportive of this group, which makes this a crazy one for sure. What is also interesting is the nod at the old times, with these pants, of course, and also the mix of current-day problems that take place in the USA right now. But be sure to continue watching, as this is not all we have to cover. Also, we have an explanation behind the Confederate pants that may just explain what's going on here. So sit back, relax, and keep on watching. Number 9. The symbolism of the lyrics. We just want a party, party just for you. We just want the money, money just for you. Lyrically, this turns the lens on the spectacle of musicians who make partying and money a central theme of their art. Party, just for you, and money, just for you, are parallel to one another because African-American culture is often stereotyped as being these types of people. Therefore, it is not for us, but rather for you. These lyrics may also be a sneak diss at many rappers in the music game right now. As most of you know, the famous rap artists who have risen to fame typically scream into the mic over a cheap beat as they talk about money and women, and then partying with these two aspects. I think this could be one of the problems that Donald Glover is trying to get off in the song, because while listening to music is not a real problem, the symbolism of solely wanting the money and partying is a big problem within the US culture, and thus leads to bigger problems. Number 8. The Horseman of the Apocalypse. As Glover continues to dance amid the chaos, with another police car parked in view, a hooded figure rides past on a white horse. Some on Twitter have drawn connections to the Horseman of the Apocalypse from the New Testament's Book of Revelation, in which death rides on a pale horse with hell following behind. We know this is likely a reference to the four horsemen of the apocalypse because of the color of the horse, which is mentioned as white in the Bible. So I looked and saw a white horse, and its rider had a bow, and he was given a crown and rode out to conquer and defeat. Revelations chapter 6, verse 2. Others say it may be the white horse referenced in the Bible, a symbol of conquest, while another user said it represented the book Behold a Pale Horse, written by Bill Cooper, former U.S. Naval Intelligence, that described conspiracies within the government to coerce the civilian population. So there are many theories behind what this horse is supposed to represent. And while we don't have a complete understanding, as Gambino was trying to go for here, we can conclude some important details about the scene. Let us know if you all have any opinions or ideas on what this horse could mean. We would love to hear your thoughts. Number 7. The juxtaposition of the happy music with the dark lyrical content. The beginning of this song starts out very kind of slow and cheery. First-time listeners may be thinking, wow, what a nice song. Just simply flowing, groovy, kind of like Redbone. Well, we quickly realize this to be false. This is supposed to be jarring. The sweet, peaceful music at the beginning is designed to lull you into a false sense of security and a belief that everything is going to be fine. The abrupt shootings and lyrics are designed to wake you up. This is a metaphor for needing to be jarred awake in order to fully process these events. With everything that has been going on in America, we really seem to just let things slide. And Gambino was going for this when he sent the message out there in his song. We must be alert and ready for anything to happen here in the USA. But what people also need to do is stay awake and stay focused on helping better the country. This is definitely a very important theme that Glover used in the song. Number 6. Two gold chains. Glover's wardrobe choice has deep ties to history as well. Not only are his pants Confederate uniform slacks, but the double gold chains are symbolic as well. The two chains represent bondage and the enslavement of African Americans during the birth of our nation. Even though technical, explicit slavery no longer exists, many are still in bondage through systemic racism and the infrastructure of modern institutions that were built on racial prejudice. The gold chains also symbolize consumerism in America and our obsession with material objects. This is definitely a very subtle theme and message that Gambino added in the music video, and I'm sure most of you missed it. What's also important to note is that the chains don't look like anything special to the meaning, as many rappers do wear expensive chains. However, this may have been Gambino's way of showing that people don't look deep into the meaning of what is going on, and only like the look of what their favorite celebrities put on. For example, there's a rapper named 2 Chainz, who, as his name suggests, literally reps 2 gold chains. This may actually be a nod at the rapper 2 Chainz, and while most think the gold has to do with some history, it may have a double meaning as to what Donald wants to get across. I'm not sure what he has to say for 2 Chainz, but if you have an idea on how this may be a correlation to the rapper, let us know in the comments down below. Yeah, yeah, or I'ma get the pad. Yeah, yeah, I'm so cold like, yeah. Yeah, I'm so dull like, yeah. Woo, we gon' blow like, yeah. Number 5. Guara Guara. While the music video has a very important and deep meaning behind it, Glover uses dance moves to make it interesting and to the point. However, among the many recognizable dances is the Guara Guara. The viral dance craze originates from South Africa and was brought to the Grammy stage by Rihanna. Incorporating the South African move has 2 very different meanings. Lightheartedly, it can be just another way to throw in a viral dance since Guara Guara inspired the Stanky Leg. However, it also draws attention to apartheid in South Africa, comparing it to how we view and treat minorities in America. This connection shows how the two systems are not that different. But what a lot of people also think, based on all the dances combined, is that Donald was trying to dance as a distraction to the people watching, or the stuff going on in the background, as, well, that's what happens in America. Number 4. Why Gambino is shirtless. If you think Gambino isn't wearing a shirt just because he wanted to show off his trim frame, you're missing the point. Glover wants to remind us that crimes are committed against African bodies like his, with some regularity, and with no heed to whether the body in question is that of a celebrity or an ordinary citizen. This is also the implication buried in the lyrics, which include the phrase, "Police be trippin' now," and which speaks of guns and my area. Glover remains without a shirt because no matter what he looks like, he knows he's going to get questioned because of his race. This is also a very important theme and relates to the idea of the dances, the police, and many other aspects of the music video. Number 3. Guns are treated better than police. As Gambino gently places his weapon in a red cloth, we see the shooting victim's body just kind of taken out of the picture. The implication that weapons are more precious than a human life can be seen twice in the video, a very accurate representation of how people live these days in the US. Not to mention, he commits a bunch of acts of crime in the music video, but the adding of the carefully placed gun on a small red carpet makes this idea even more interesting and to the point. With everything that has been happening in the USA recently, it's not a surprise that Donald feels people treat their precious piece of metal better than humans themselves. Number 2. The Jim Crow Pose. It's also been suggested that the pose Gambino pulls before taking his first victim, played by artist Calvin II, is a reference to Jim Crow, a theatrical racist stereotype created in the 19th century. The name was later used as the name for racial segregation laws in the US, before evolving once again into a term to describe the politics in America by Michelle Alexander, author of The New Jim Crow. Alongside the performative element of the video and the range of dramatic facial expressions pulled by Childish Gambino, he could be seen to embody different stereotypes throughout the video, from the violent aggressor to the entertainer to the hunted. As you all can see from the picture, Glover's hand placement and pose looks exactly like that of the Jim Crow painting. As we mentioned earlier, Glover goes from everything from old times to current problems, but this may also be meaning towards the fact that this racism still exists. While it may be illegal, many people still remain racist to his kind, and the Jim Crow pose is just one of the nods at this theme.
I'm on Gucci. I'm so pretty. Yeah, yeah. I'm on get it. Watch me move.
Number 1. The Constant Distraction. Throughout the video, Childish Gambino and his actors use dance as a distraction from the brutality unfolding around them. This can be seen as a reflection of how we live and function in online spaces in 2018. The forums we use allow two opposing forces, of joy and horror, to coexist as spectacles of viral memes fill our feeds interchangeably. As Gambino rattles off the lyrics, "Hunted bands, hunted bands, hunted bands, contraband, contraband, contraband."
Hunted bands, hunted bands, hunted bands, contraband, contraband, contraband.
He demonstrates a hip-hop trope, money, and the pursuit of superficial success as a distraction topic from the real oppression and problems taking place on the ground. In one scene, as the camera pans between shots, we also catch a glimpse of a few teens recording the events on their phones from a safe distance. In this way, pop culture content is, and always has been, both a subconscious smokescreen and a conscious coping mechanism for many. People need to change, and sitting there, recording what's going on, and dancing in the background may not be the only ways we are distracted. But this is a message towards the idea of how the United States acts towards problems.
Just another reminder to enter the iPhone 10 giveaway we have going on. All you guys need to do is subscribe, turn on post notifications, drop a like, and comment the hidden message in the video. Thank you for watching till the end, and be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you're new. And I'll see you guys later in the next video. Peace.